Yes. Okay, whiteboard. Yes. Students, today we are going to discuss about simple pendulum. And its time period. Derivation is important for you for board exam. You can expect this question. Yes. What is a simple pendulum, Nana? Simple pendulum is nothing but one rigid bob having some mass is suspended from a rigid support with the help of inextensible massless string. Okay, now if this bob is given a small push or pull, okay, means if its height is raised somewhat and released, then what happened? It will come back like this to this position. We call it as mean position. Again, from this position, it will rise to some height. Clear? And up to here like this. Again, it will go like this. Again, it will come back to mean position. This is one oscillation. Again, it will go this side again. Again, it will go like this. Continuously, it will move to and fro motion about a mean position. Means it is performing simple harmonic motion. Okay. So for this, what is the time period of this simple pendulum? We need to calculate. Okay. So for that, what we are doing is, let us suppose, I'll draw somewhat big this diagram so that you will understand clearly. Okay. Yes. This is the string and this is the bob. Okay. Now, raise it by some distance. Here it is there now. Okay. Now at this position, this bob is having some mass, no? Yes or no? Yes. As this bob is having some mass, now this weight of the bob is acting this side like this, mg. Correct? Yes. It is raised here. Okay. Yes. This is extreme position. Here, at this extreme position, weight of the bob is acting vertically downward. Whereas some tension is acting here like this. In this direction, some tension is acting. Correct? Yes. Now, this tension, let us suppose when the bob is raised by up by some angle theta. When the bob is raised up by some angle theta, then if this is theta, then this is also theta. Yes or no? Are you understanding? Clear? Any doubt in this? I think so, no doubt. Because this and this are vertical lines. And this is an inclined line which is intersecting. Then these two angles, theta and this theta, should be equal. Okay? Now, this mg, we can resolve into two components. They are here, mg cos theta. Where angle is there? That's said mg cos theta. Exactly perpendicular to that. Means along these dotted lines. This will be mg sin theta. Clear? Yes. Now, this force, mg sin theta. Now, mg sin theta is the restoring force to pull the bob back to its position. Yes or no? Rahul is saying, sir, screen is not visible. Is it happening for all students? Oh, is it recording? I think so. I forgot to record. Is it recording, friends? Is it recording? I forgot to record it. So, recording? Huh? Okay, no problem. Huh. they are saying, students, they are saying that it is Rahul, it is, they are saying that it is visible. Recording, no? Is it recording or not? Oh, it is recording, no problem. Okay. Yeah. Did you understand? Mg sin theta. Mg sin theta is the reshoring force which will pull the bob back to its position. Correct? Yes. Now, what is the force? Which force is responsible for this pendulum to pull it back? Is it mg sin theta or mg cos theta? See, mg cos theta balances the tension in the string. Mg cos theta balances the tension in the string, Nana. Okay. Whereas mg sin theta pulls the bob back, means at this extension position, at this extreme position, write the net force acting on it. What is the net force acting on that bob? Okay, net force acting on the bob is now, there is F is equal to mg sin theta, and that too is acting towards the mean position. So minus mg sin theta, I'll write. Did you understand what I am saying? Why I have written minus? Did you understand? Because it is acting towards the mean position. It is acting backside. Because it is a restoring force. Clear, students? Yes. Now, if, see, one condition is important here. If theta is small, for small angular displacements condition, then sine theta, we can take it nearly equal to theta. Okay, it is nearly equal to theta, we can take. Okay, that means this force can be written as F is equal to minus mg into theta. Any doubt in that? Yes. Now, see this diagram. Let us suppose here I'll draw one vertical horizontal line for this, like this. I'll draw one horizontal line like this for this diagram. Okay. This is a right angle triangle here. Okay, clear, students? Yes. From here to here, this length is nothing but length of the pendulum. Correct? Yes, this is also length of the pendulum, and this is also length of the pendulum. Simple pendulum length it is. Okay, and this is the distance x it is displaced, let us suppose. Okay, now. Clear? Now, if theta is small, then sine theta can be written as theta, and theta can be written as tan theta. I already told you. Means this can be written as F is equal to minus mg tan theta. Okay. Or otherwise, if you don't want these all things, means simply you erase these all things. No need these all things. Sin theta only, let us keep. Okay. Yes. Now here see F, you know, if this is F, no, yes. Mg sin theta. Okay. F is equal to minus mg. What is sin theta from this triangle? From this triangle. Can you see this? Yes. Sin theta is opposite side by hypotenuse. Okay. Opposite side is X, hypotenuse is L. Yes, good. X by L. Yes. Now, as we know, according to Newton's second law, we know that F is equal to ma. Correct? It implies ma is equal to minus mg x by L. X by L. Are you understanding? Mm cancel. It is in the form of a is equal to minus g by L into x. Okay. For simple harmonic motion, we know, compare this equation. If a particle is performing simple harmonic motion, whose acceleration is equal to minus omega square x. Yes, this we have derived. That implies omega square is nothing but g by L. Correct? Then omega value what, Nana? Omega is equal to root g by L. Are you understanding? Root g by L. Clear, students? We know time period t is equal to 2 pi by omega. Correct? Yes. Then time period of the simple pendulum is equal to 2 pi under root of g by L. That means it will become t is equal to 2 pi root L by g. Yes. Formula for time period of a simple pendulum. Okay. Clear, students? This is one method to find. Another method is also here. This method, did you understand? You tell me first. Did you understand or not this method? Step by step, I am showing you one more time. Nitya, yes. No need to consider small angle. If you don't consider directly x sin theta is equal to x by L, substitute. Okay. Another method is there, that is there in your subjective material, which I have given for you. In that material, another method also is there. Okay. That let us find. Let us do that one. With that method, let us do. Okay, means which method is convenient for you, that method you saw. Okay, now see, this is the simple pendulum. Now, Bob, let us suppose it is raised by some height. Okay, this will be mg, correct. Yes, this is theta, then this is also theta. This is mg, then this is also theta. Okay, now it can be resolved into this is mg cos theta. And this is mg sin theta. Okay. Now you tell me here. See this mg cos theta, this is tension, Anna. This is acting. Mg cos theta and tension, they are acting radially. They can't rotate the bob. Whereas mg sin theta, it can rotate. Correct? Yes. Okay, that means there is some torque is acting. The torque is due to mg sin theta. Are you understanding what I am saying? Means that bob is rotating like this. When it is rotating, when it will rotate, when some force is acting on an object, and when it is rotating about one fixed point, about this fixed point, it is rotating. Means some torque is acting on it. How much torque acting? We know torque formula. Tau is equal to force into perpendicular distance. clear? Force into perpendicular distance. Okay. Is it clear, students? Now, this torque can be written as, what is the force which is rotating this bob? That is mg sin theta. Well, as mg cos theta, it cannot rotate. Mg cos theta, it cannot rotate. Only mg sin theta, it can rotate. Mg sin theta into, what is the perpendicular distance from this? From this mg sin theta, perpendicular distance is nothing but length of the pendulum, we can say is L. Because this mg sin theta is perpendicular to this. It's perpendicular to this. Okay. This length of the pendulum. Okay. Yes. Now we can say torque tau acting on it is nothing but tau is equal to m g l sin theta. Now consider for small angles. Why it is not moving? Wait, students, it is stuck right into. System hanged, Nana. It is not responding. I am unable to write at least. Now, if theta is small, then sine theta can be replaced with theta. Yo, why it is happening like this? He's not responding. What to do? Can you hear me? I'm unable to see your what is that one? Voice also means messages also. Something, three messages I got. It is not opening. If you can hear my voice, please send me a message. What happened to you? you are able to hear, then why it is not moving? These all things, just the screen is not moving, Nana. What happened? Definitely I'll save. No option is coming. Just I can write and I can erase. That's it. I can't do anything else because here place is not there to write. Yes, Rani. Yes, Rani. Can you, are you able to see this, whatever I am writing? But it is not moving. Further to write, a place is not there for me. That's why I am waiting, whether it will come or not, like that. Video and audio clear, huh? Can you hear me now? Yes, it came, I think so. That whiteboard. Yes, yes, yes. Be patient, Nana. Be patient. I'll explain that one. This is online teaching. This is only headache. Too much headache it is. Yes, it came now. Good. Yes, see students, here MGL sin theta written, and now sin theta can be replaced with theta, means star tau. Tau will become MGL theta. And here, this torque is acting towards the mean portion. So we can write minus sign here. Okay. And one more thing, we know that torque acting on a torque formula is tau is equal to I alpha. In a system of particles and rotatory motion, we have discussed. Torque tau is equal to I alpha, we have discussed. Here, that means I alpha is equal to minus MGL theta. Then alpha can be written as MGL divided by I. I means what? Moment of inertia. Yes. Now, I means moment of inertia. Now, it is in the form of A is equal to minus omega square x. Means in angular motion, we can write in the place of A, we can write alpha is equal to minus omega square and in the place of x we can write angular displacement theta. Means compare this one with this equation. Okay, we can get omega square angular frequency angular velocity is equal to mgl by I. Angular acceleration alpha means angular acceleration. Anna, yes, someone is asking question. Abhay, alpha means angular acceleration. This means angular acceleration. Angular acceleration, linear acceleration, angular acceleration, linear displacement x, angular displacement theta. Okay, yes. Now omega square is equal to mgl by I. Then what is omega? Nana, omega is under root of mgl by I. I is moment of inertia about a point of rotation, means about its center of mass, you can say. Okay, now its time period can be written as t is equal to, time period can be written as t is equal to 2 pi by omega, you know. So t is equal to 2 pi divided by root mgl by I, because omega is, I have written. Then time period is equal to 2 pi root I by mgl. Okay, we know moment of inertia of a simple pendulum which is rotating about a fixed point is nothing but I is equal to ml square. Okay, then substitute, you will get t is equal to 2 pi under root of m l square divided by mgl. Mm cancel, 1l 1l cancel, you will get t is equal to, hey, t is equal to, you get t is equal to 2 pi under root of l by g. Here, yes, this is the formula for the time period of a simple pendulum. I hope you got it. Okay, this method is there in your subjective material. Anna, in your subjective material this method is there. Okay, you read this one. If you are not understanding this one, means previous one which already I have explained you here. This one here, yeah, this one you can write. Okay, I'll share this one in your WhatsApp group. Okay, see your what is that one, I'll show you the material also. Yeah, here it is. First few notes. No, not this. Yeah, oscillations chapter. Important question for your board exam. Okay. Yes, see this one, Anna, simple pendulum. Okay, whatever I have explained, it is there in this material. Once you read it, you will understand. Okay, see, alpha is equal to mgl by I, I have written into sin theta. When theta is small, sin theta can be written as theta. So alpha is equal to mgl by I into theta. It is compared with alpha is equal to minus omega square theta. And omega square is equal to mgl by I. So omega is equal to root mgl by I. So because omega is 2 pi by t, so it is t is equal to 2 pi root I by mgl. Since moment of inertia of one point mass which is rotating about, it's a fixed point, is nothing but I is equal to mx square, mr square, we have written no formula, I is equal to mr square. No, moment of inertia, for example, one fixed rod is there. Okay, this is the point, axis of point about which it is rotating. and here mass is there m, and this distance is x. Then what is the moment of inertia about this axis? Moment of inertia is equal to m into x square, mass into square of the distance. You know this moment of inertia. That only it is here. Okay. Yeah, definitely. Okay. Then LL cancel, you'll get C equal to 2 pi root L by G. Yes. This question, it will come for your exam, definitely. This question will come for your exam, definitely. Okay. Read this question in board exam. Definitely, you may get this question, Nana. Students, you read this question. Again, stop. Okay, students. This is what we want to discuss in today's class. Next class we will continue. You join in your next which class is there, into that class you join. Okay, bye.